After the disappointment of the Mickey Mouse Firehouse, I didn't think I was gonna buy a single one of Disney's 4+ sets ever again. However, they actually did something that I'd been hoping that they'd do for several years, and that is make one with other Disney character minifigures. For anyone who doesn't know, this year is 100 years of Disney, and that has finally given me something that I have always wanted ever since I was a kid, and that is Disney minifigures. I mean, we've had it a couple of times before, firstly with the Disney CMF series in 2016, which also gave us the beautiful Walt Disney World Castle in Lego form, which was my first ever direct-to-consumer set. And then we had a follow-up series in 2018, which admittedly didn't feel quite as strong, but was still amazing and also gave us the Disneyland train station. And then in 2023, Lego and Disney have gone all out, giving us so many amazing sets and probably even more on the way. When I was younger, Lego Disney was something I always wanted. I mean, luckily for me, I sort of grew up in the golden era of that with Lego Toy Story and Cars and Pirates of the Caribbean, and as well as the time where they were just making one-off random movies like The Prince of Persia and The Lone Ranger. And while that doesn't exactly happen anymore, in 2014, Lego Disney Princess started to become a thing, going off the mini dolls that were introduced in the Friends series, which was an exciting step, but one that I didn't really necessarily want. I saw them and I couldn't help but think how much better this would have been for minifigures. And I say that as a very, very personal preference. I think the mini dolls have been a fantastic success for Lego, and there are some amazing mini doll Lego Disney sets like the Madrigal House, Rapunzel's Tower, Cinderella's Carriage, as well as the Tiny Little Books. I think these are all fantastic, but nothing brings me quite the same joy as the Disney minifigure sets. The Up House is certainly a standout in this regard, and I made an entire review on it if you want to check it out. But another one that stood out to me was the 4+ Disney Birthday Train. Now, firstly, it has Moana as a minifigure, and that is really what sold me on this set, because I want to have all of the Disney princesses as minifigures eventually, and just getting another one to now make it 5 was so exciting for me. Secondly, it reminds me of the Disney parks, and as someone who is fortunate enough to grow up going to those theme parks, it brings me such immense joy. It says it's technically a birthday train, but in reality, this basically to me feels like a parade set. There are 4 different carriages, starting off with Mickey Mouse's engine, and then as you go along, there are 3 different carriages that represent various Disney films, starting off with Peter Pan. And Peter Pan is such a classic, and it is really, really cool to see it replicated here on a tiny scale. I mean, ideally, I would love a full-size playset Jolly Roger, but just getting this in general is a fantastic start. Peter Pan is brought back from the CMF and a little bit simplified, and Tinkerbell, the same deal from the Disney castle, but with an improvement on the wing front. I think she looks incredible. We also got this little Sheriff Woody's Roundup type of thing, using his same version from Toy Story 4, and I just love that Sheriff print in general. And then lastly is Moana, with a really, really beautiful build, which kind of reminds me of Tafiti, but it also does not represent her at all. And just the fact that she was included, giving us another minifigure, is so great. I have said this for a while, but I feel like Disney making minifigure sets has been a sort of no-brainer move. It is an instant cash grab. The times that I have been to the Downtown Disney store and Disney Springs store, all of those Disney minifigure sets, and admittedly as well, a lot of the mini doll ones, just fly off shelves. People are obsessed. The mini Disney castle, the full-size Disney castle, besides the fact that these people are tourists and would have to transport that home, as well as Rapunzel's Tower, the Madrigal House, and I feel like this Up House and the 4+ train are gonna be no different. And in 2023, Disney also brought back a lot of brickheads, and while getting sets as brickheads really isn't my favorite thing, I do have to admit they are absolutely adorable, with Wally and Eve being the standout. And I even went against my own word and bought 2 other brickhead sets, and I hate to admit it, but I absolutely love these. They are adorable, and I just feel like all of this stuff together is going to look fantastic, and to be honest, brings me so much joy. And I hope that this isn't a 1-year thing. Having Lightyear last year not just be consistently made up of 4+ sets like The Incredibles and Toy Story 4 seemed like a good step in the right direction, and the 100th anniversary seems like an even bigger step. I mean, in recent years, we've had Winnie the Pooh from Ideas, and now we have all of this as well. And I'm starting to think that Lego does see the potential when it comes to minifigures as well as Lego sets. For me, I always thought bringing minifigures into Lego Disney would be a great stepping stone for a lot of fans of the mini doll sets to get into the rest of the world of Lego, introducing them to minifigures and just more, I guess, typical typical Lego building using a lot smaller pieces and not quite the same dollhouse large elements that often those mini doll sets would have. And in my head, the best way to do that was by having mini doll sets exist, but also have some minifigure sets on shelves at the same time. They can both exist. You don't have to get rid of one to have the other. I feel like if you had both of them, it would be great for every single fan. And also just because of the giant mega corporation Disney is and the large part of people's lives that it is, it would be such an easy way to bring in a lot of people into the hobby as well as just expand them to the wide world of Lego. Over the last 13 years, Lego has really expanded on the Disney range. And I mean, it has taken some time, but I feel like we're at a point where we have really got a perfect mix of everything. And while I feel like modern Lego often cuts corners and also oversizes and overcharges for things, I feel like Lego Disney for the most part has been pretty reasonable in that regard. Out of the sets I've bought and the things that I've built so far, I really feel like it's only the brickheads that do feel a little cheap, I want to say, in comparison to what older brickheads used to be like, just from a how many exclusive or printed parts view there is. Otherwise, I think the builds are fantastic, and the Up House and the Disney Train as well were amazing. I mean, being a 4+ Disney set, of course the 4+ set is going to feel very, very expensive for what it is, and there is no denying that. I definitely do feel like it was expensive, but it is a set that makes me really, really happy. I probably should have bought it on sale, but honestly, I just got too excited and didn't want to wait. And it looks like there's gonna be more coming out at the end of the year as well. I mean, just take a look at the Disney Series 3 CMF, which again, I am very, very excited for and really do not wanna wait until June for Lego to release it in Australia. That absolutely sucks firstly, but there is so many minifigures in that series that are amazing. I think this has to be one of, if not the best minifigure series that Lego has ever done. And I mean, honestly, I wanna say Series 1 was better, and that's purely because I guess of the nostalgia aspect I have from it. But objectively, Series 3 is fantastic. However, you will notice that there are some pretty notable inclusions missing from that CMF, which I'm sure the first ones that come to mind are gonna be Snow White, Cinderella, Belle and the Beast. These guys are so incredibly popular. I mean, Belle and the Beast were some of the first ever Disney brickheads. Cinderella is probably the most produced Disney princess in mini doll form, and Snow White is the original Disney princess and even made her way into a brickhead. And notice too how these characters have popped up various times in Lego's history, but never as a minifigure. It honestly seems like there is something coming with all of them. There are a couple of rumors for some upcoming Lego Disney sets, two of which we know and have some very strong evidence for, and that is the Snow White Cottage as well as a Maleficent Dragon type of set. And these, again, make me so excited to be able to get the Evil Queen in the CMF, and then all of the Seven Dwarves and Snow White in a cottage is going to be fantastic. It sucks that they're going to be locking away Snow White behind a pretty high entry point in terms of sets, especially for the young children that would be interested in Lego Disney. However, the fact that it is getting made, it makes me very excited in general, and is probably going to be one of my favorite and most anticipated sets of the year. Same deal with the Maleficent Dragon. I just think that's going to be fantastic. And given that there are giant models of the Maleficent Dragon as well as Prince Philip outside the Downtown Disney and Disney Springs stores, I'm honestly surprised it's taken that long to get something in minifigure form. That model is fantastic, and I cannot wait to have a version that I can put on my shelf. However, with those two sets, there are still some notable inclusions. So where is Cinderella gonna go, and where are Belle and the Beast gonna go? Honestly, I don't know. Could this be a 2023 thing, or could this potentially be expensive for 2024? Maybe 2023 is a test to see how well minifigures and Disney do in general, and maybe they'll continue to produce more in the upcoming future. And as much as I feel like Lego does produce too many sets these days, it's something I do have to be a hypocrite about, because that is something that I personally would really love to see. I would love to see a diorama of the Belle and the Beast castle. I would love to see Aurora's castle from Disneyland become a set just like Cinderella's was in Walt Disney World. I would love for Cinderella to appear in a minifigure set somehow in some way, whether that be a 4+ train like this, like Moana did, or whether it be in another CMF series, which honestly I don't think is gonna happen anytime soon. But to be so close to having every single Disney princess in minifigure form, I feel like maybe Lego will actually go ahead and do this. At this point, we're only missing 5, Rapunzel, Merida, Snow White, Cinderella, and Belle, and I feel like these could all pop up in more 4+ style sets like this. In an ideal world, we would have more sets like the Up House, but if our way of getting Disney minifigures and just Disney classic animation IPs pop up in Lego form is through 4+ sets, I will gladly jump upon this bandwagon. I would absolutely love to see more Peter Pan sets, a 101 Dalmatian set, a Jungle Book set, anything Disney princess related as well. I can also see them doing Zootopia or maybe a Big Hero 6 set. There is just so many different different things to choose from. 2023 has been amazing for LEGO Disney so far, and I am so glad that I am able to sort of live through it and go and buy and collect all of these things. I want to make a massive display and just pull out all of my old sets from when I was a kid. It makes me want to go back and buy the ones that I missed. Like, I've been looking at the Ariel and Ursula brickheads. LEGO Disney has got me in a chokehold, and I'm trying to be good with my money right now, so I'm trying not to buy too much, but honestly, I don't think that that's exactly happening. So as a result, I'm probably gonna dig through my collection and see what sets I'm not super interested in anymore and go and sell them, because this type of stuff is what I really, really want to be collecting and buying right now. If you're like me and you're a massive Disney fan, I hate to say it, but honestly, go and vote with your wallet. And that doesn't mean go and pick things up on release day if you think that they're too expensive. If they go on sale or there is a good deal or a good promotion, then is the time to buy. And that is a large reason as well that I decided to go and just buy the full Disney train set rather than just buy the Moana and Tinkerbell minifigures. I wanted to vote with my wallet, and also I had the opportunity to get it early, so you know, I also couldn't say no to that too. But that being said, be smart with your money. I mean, Disney is already expensive enough as is. It makes sense that LEGO Disney is also quite pricey, and these brickheads now have a chokehold on me. I hope you guys enjoyed this little rambly discussion about LEGO Disney, and if you did, please give me a thumbs up, consider subscribing to my channel down below, and until next time guys, I'll see you later.